Hey y'all, welcome to my kitchen today. My kitchen has actually grown a little bit. Michael's now added to the bunch, so it's Aunt Peggy, Michael, Teresa, Eddie, and me, and of course three dogs and a cat. And that's our crazy house. I am going to show y'all today probably the number one most popular recipe that I have ever printed and shared. And this recipe was given to me. I can't take credit for it. This recipe was given to me by a woman in Jacksonville that I liked very, very much. She was so funny. She sent me the recipe and she said, "Paula, this ain't my mama's banana pudding. This is good." So it got hung with that name, Nacho Mama's Banana Pudding. And I don't care where I go in this United States, whether it's the Midwest, the Pacific side, or the Atlantic side, somebody is gonna say something about Nacho Mama's Banana Pudding. And I have to say, it's the best no-cook banana pudding I've ever eaten. And it's real easy to make.
I can even do it.
Huh? Yes, Michael can even do it. No cook at all. So I have the pudding mixed up here. Now, we're using a 5-ounce box of instant vanilla pudding, and it will tell you to add 3 cups of cold water. But for this, don't go by that recipe. Use 2 cups of cold water. Cold milk. I'm sorry. No, don't make pudding with water. That would be awful. So, 2 cups of milk to a 5-ounce box of banana pudding. A 5-ounce box of French vanilla pudding and 2 cups of cold milk. Now, in this bowl, we have what is equivalent to a 12-ounce container. Oh no, this is an 8-ounce container of a whipped topping. I personally don't care for whipped toppings. I always substitute, if the recipe calls for a frozen whipped topping, I always make my own fresh cream. And I mix up to 1 cup of heavy cream, I'll add 1/4 cup of sugar. And to me, that makes it the perfect sweetness. So I'm taking this out of the picture because this is fresh whipped cream. All right, now in this bowl, I've got 1 8-ounce package of softened cream cheese. And to that, I'm gonna add 1 can of sweetened condensed milk. And this stuff is so good. And every time I open a can of this and use it, y'all, I think about the one time that we had 17 inches of snow and I made snow ice cream. I would go out and get a bowl of nice clean snow, no yellow snow, no brown snow, but pure white snow. And I would pour a can of sweetened condensed milk into that ice cream with a little teaspoon of vanilla. That is the best ice cream you'll ever put in your mouth. So if you're somewhere in this country and still getting snow, please make some snow cream because it's out of this world. All right, so I'm gonna take my little hand mixer and I'm just gonna beat that up because you want your cream cheese kind of smooth. And mine was nice and soft, so it's gonna smooth out very, very good. So now all we've got to do is incorporate these three bowls together. So that's our sweetened condensed milk, that is, and our cream cheese. Now I'm gonna stir in our vanilla pudding, which we beat with 2 cups of cold milk. And we're gonna fold this together. and Nacho Mama's banana pudding calls for little chessmen cookies. But I have found that a shortbread cookie works very well too. I can't actually remember the name of it. Maybe Walter's, but it's a shortbread cookie and it comes in a plaid wrap. And those are really, really good shortbread cookies. And that works just as well too. Or you can even use a homemade shortbread cookie. All right, so now in goes our whipped cream. I was actually showing y'all the wrong size because I think I said a 12-ounce container, and that's what you're supposed to use, a 12-ounce container of frozen whipped topping. So that's the smallest size that they make. All right, so we're gonna stir this in. Just fold, fold, fold. Yum, yum, yum. Mmm. Mm-mm-mm. And that fresh whipped cream, it just makes all the difference in the world, y'all, to me, in this dish. All right. The recipe calls for 2 sacks of the chessmen cookies. I find that I usually need 3. All right, now I wanna talk to you about bananas. I sliced my bananas and I sprinkled fruit fresh on them to keep them from turning dark. And we're fixing to put this together. I'll move my cutting board. And we are gonna line the bottom with our chessmen cookies. And these little cookies, they're really good, y'all. All right, I'm gonna turn them up so they'll all look like chess pieces. Okay, now here's something else that we need to talk about. You would have to determine this yourself. Do you like more custard or do you like more fruit? I like more custard. I just do. So, I think the recipe calls for like 8. Let's see what it calls for. It calls for 6 to 8 bananas sliced, and I think I have 6. So it goes on to tell you to pour the mixture over the cookies and bananas, and then I think this calls for like doing 2 layers of it, but I do more than that. So here we go. I'm gonna put some bananas over it. And like I said, I just like more custard and cookies than I do bananas. So here we go. So many girls have told me that this recipe just made them a star. And that makes me so happy to hear that. All right. This stuff makes a whole lot of custard, which works out good for me. All right. Cookies. That last layer, you'll want to keep them straight and pretty, but this one's going to be covered up. So, It's all right if they're a little cockeyed. So I've already gone through the two boxes, y'all. I'm just going, okay, so that gives us two layers of bananas. All right. One thing about banana pudding, y'all, you have to eat it pretty quickly before your bananas start turning dark.
That's not gonna be a problem.
You think you're going to be able to finish this, Grover?
Yeah,
I will do. I mean, it's taking every bit of that cream. This is perfect, y'all. Just coming out perfect. And you'll want to make sure you cover those bananas, because if they're exposed to air, they will brown a lot faster. I can't resist it. Yum. That is so good. It tastes like the richest of ice creams. It does, it tastes like ice creams. All right, so now if you've just bought two bags of Chessmen cookies, you're gonna be short on the top. So that's why I recommend three boxes. Isn't that pretty? Yes, ma'am, it's pretty. All right, third sack, y'all. Oh, and I want to tell y'all, I have asked y'all to send in suggestions, anything that you want to see prepared, and, a friend of ours from up north, Gail, she has asked me to make a peanut butter pie. And so I'm definitely going to do that one soon, because you're talking about an easy pie. That is so good. And it's basically a no cook one. So Gail, I'm going to be doing that one soon. And what else did somebody ask for, Michael? Well, Eddie, what did somebody ask for?
You've gotten a lot for
we've
chicken
had a bunch.
And rice.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, the chicken salad. They wanted a chicken casserole recipe, and I made that yesterday. So I'll be making that again soon, because Aunt Peggy said that was the best meal she's had since she's been here in 3 weeks. A chicken and rice casserole. It's just easy.
Never had one before. We never have even considered.
I know, that's not your kind of cooking. Aunt Peggy's never been a casserole maker. All right, so y'all, that's it. Nacho Mama's banana pudding. She's a winner every time. Love and best dishes, y'all.